bit of a recap for the festival here, and some good music all weekend. We had Guster and G-Love and Special Sauce on Friday night. We had Vintage Blue, Third Eye Blind, and the Mobleys on Saturday. So it's been a solid weekend of live music in the West Loop. And now let's get right to it. Let's bring in Father Tom Hurley. Father Tom, thanks once again here. Second straight year. Thanks for joining me on the Rock and Roll Radio program. How are you, sir?
I'm doing okay. Doing okay. Thank you.
Well, it's my pleasure to have you on the show here once again. And I do feel the need to remind you that you and I share an alma mater on the city of Chicago's south side.
That's right. That's right. I forgot about that. What class were you?
the class of 1997.
Oh, you're just a baby boy, for God's sake. Oh, my God, 97.
Please, I wish that was the case. All right, Father, as you know, the world's largest block party going on this Friday and Saturday downtown in the West Loop, pretty well known as a singles event. I am a single guy, and I'm really getting sick of hearing everything from from family members. Am I gonna find somebody at this festival?
We hope so. We'll see what we can do for you. We'll get a nice girl. Marist guys only get nice girls. So
thank you. I need all the help I can get.
Hopefully that's not recorded.
I don't know what you're talking about. All right, Father, do me a favor, please, because I did not prep for this interview.
It's all right.
Refresh my memory. How long were you at? How long have you been at Old St. Pat's?
Well, that's a very interesting question. I came here when I was a knucklehead right out of college. So that was probably in 1989, 1990, when you were still in diapers.
That's true.
And but as a priest, as the pastor, this would be my 11th year. Yeah, so I came here in 2003, officially on the staff.
I don't have to tell you how many festivals there are now, obviously. You know, street festivals in the city of Chicago, even in major festivals, you know, like Lollapalooza and all that stuff.
Yeah, sure.
So many choices every single weekend. But this festival manages to kind of, you know, still be a highlight after all these years. What is it exactly that sets the world's largest block party apart from the festival glut going on in the city of Chicago?
Well, first of all, you know, this is the 30th anniversary of this thing. So, which means that when you've got a party that's been going on for 30 years, I don't know too many other events that have been going on for 30 years. That's pretty notable in and of itself. And, you know, obviously it's a party that's been around for three decades, and it's one that, you know, now has become generational. So it continues to be handed on to future generations, and it's just a fun summertime party that has a great reputation, you know. And it's not a lot when you're talking about bringing together some good people and have some good music and a few beverages and just a fun time. So I think it's a real simple party that's got a great name associated with it.
AM 1420 WIMS, the talk of the South Shore, the rock and roll radio program tonight until 7 p.m. when Jim LaRocco takes over with Miscellany. Stick around for that. My name is Jim Ryan, and we're chatting right now with Father Tom Hurley, aspiring stand-up comic and pastor of Old St. Patrick's Church in the city of Chicago's West Side, which has been home all weekend to the world's largest block party, Friday night performances, Guster and G-Love and Special Sauce, Saturday night, the Mowgli's, Vintage Blue, who you're going to hear from later on this program, as well as headliner Third Eye Blind, and the 30th year of the world's largest block party. Father, you know, obviously the money going to Old St. Patrick's Church, but where exactly, like what exactly is it the block party funding?
Well, it's supporting, number one, you know, kind of the overall ministries of Old St. Patrick's. I mean, St. Pat's has become, I think, a signature church in the Chicagoland area. We have people that come here from over 200 zip codes around Chicago and Northwest Indiana. People appreciate the ministries that we do. I suppose the one thing that we become very, very known for in our ministries is really the extensive outreach, social outreach missions that we have. And so this block party helps us to keep alive all of our missions, but in particular, our social outreach missions service.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, I think another interesting element, not just of the world's largest block party, but in specific regard to Old St. Pat's, is the fact that you guys do attract a really young demo.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah, we do. We seem to attract a younger crowd, and I think a lot of that has to do with the entertainment. And the party it was designed that way. It was designed to be kind of a young adult party. That was intentional 30 years ago, and it has stayed that way ever since. So we've done it just in terms of like band and entertainment, and I mean, let's face it, I don't know about you because you're 12 years younger than me, but I mean my crowd, people who are 47 and graduated from Marist in 1985, I mean, this is not their thing anymore. Going outside and going to summer festivals and standing on a parking lot and drinking draft beer is not exactly something that we look for anymore. We did that. I did that routine. I do it now because I'm the pastor here and I enjoy it. But I mean, let's face it. I've graduated to Ravinia, for God's sake, But it is, and we've done it that way, and we've been able to recruit kind of the next generation of young adults who run the party and are able to kind of bring a great twist of entertainment that I've not heard of them, but other people have. And again, you're not looking to attract me. You're looking to attract people in their 20s and 30s,
Oh, come on now. I'm not buying that one. You told me last year you enjoyed the Counting Crows a number of years ago. You have to remember Third Eye Blind.
Sure, I do. Third Eye Blind is the one that I'm most familiar with, and I do like their music, and so I'm really looking forward to them. Actually, Guster was here a few years ago, and they were really, really good, and I enjoyed them as well. So,
Well, Guster and G Love and Special Sauce performing Friday night at the world's largest block party, Old St. Patrick's Church in the downtown Chicago West Loop area. Saturday night, pretty good as well. Vintage Blue, Third Eye Blind, the Mowglies, a lot of bands performing. Can you possibly put in a word with someone, Father, to keep the rain away this year?
Oh yeah, no worries, no worries. There won't be any rain. No
Good.
rain.
I'm gonna hold you to that.
And you know what? That rain. You were here Friday night, I believe.
Both nights, but yeah, Friday
Oh
was.
yeah, Friday night is when we got really drenched, but that was for like 10 minutes, and that was just really to kind of clean off any spilled beer on the parking lot. That's all that was. So.
Well, yeah. I mean, you'll get that. And speaking of that, let's tell people one of the biggest selling points of the world's largest block party. One of the points that in my mind kind of sets it apart from every other festival going on during the summer, and that's free beer.
Oh yeah, that's the other thing. I mean, that's why this party is attractive and why it has been attractive. And again, I remember it when I was, getting out of college and coming down to this party before I was even a priest. I came to this party and with guys I went to Marist with. And but the nice thing about it then and now is that you pay one price. So it's $40, and it includes great entertainment and four free beverages of either beer, wine, soda, or water, whatever you want to use it on, But it's $40 plus for, beverages. That's a pretty good deal.
Speaking with Father Tom Hurley, pastor of Old St. Patrick's Church, home of the 30th annual World's Largest Block Party, which has been going on all weekend. Friday, Guster and G-Lovin' Special Sauce. Saturday, the Mowglies, Vintage Blue. You're going to hear them later on this program. Ben Bassett of Vintage Blue stopping by and performing live in the studio. Don't go anywhere. But Third Eye Blind also performing Saturday night. And again, this is all at the World's Largest Block Party. Check them out online. Father, I want to get back to the single ladies because I need one, but also because this festival is kind of renowned for putting people together. I mean, it's something you guys hang your hat on. Do you have an exact number of couples that have come away from this event married?
You know what? There's absolutely no possible way for us to have an exact number because we have no idea once people leave here, how many actually continue to see each other and fall in love and get married and all that stuff. But what we do know of, I think our tracking is somewhere in the area of at least 100 couples in its 30-year period. At least 100 couples met here first, laid their eyes on each other first, and then went on and got married. I've done some of those weddings, so I know that's true.
That's impressive and frightening all at the same time.
Yeah, it sure is.
All right, Father, I'll get you out of here on this one. Somebody came up with the bright idea that I should be a celebrity, air quotes here, celebrity bartender. I'll be doing that Friday night. Are you a little bit worried about attendance as a result of that?
Of course, if you're not going to be here, then
No, that's the thing. I am going to
Oh,
be
you
there.
are going to
That's
be here. Oh, I thought you said you weren't going to be
Yeah,
here.
you should be worried.
Oh, you're going to be here. So, all right. Well, we're going to have to prepare for that. Yeah, we're going to hit the ground running a little harder these before the party.
All right, you know him from the PBS stand-up series, the Chicago Stand-Up Project. Hopefully you know him better as the pastor of Old St. Patrick's Church in downtown Chicago, where you should stop and attend the world's largest block party this weekend. A lot of great music going on. 4 free beers with each paid admission. Single ladies, I'll be making an ass out of myself in the celebrity bartender line. There's really no reason not to attend the world's largest block party. Let's just hope there's no rain.
Oh, that'd be great.
Father Tom Hurley, always a pleasure. Appreciate it very much you taking some time out here to join me on the Rock and Roll Radio program.
Jim, thank you, buddy. I really appreciate it.
Oh, Father Tom cracks me up. He's a funny guy and a good guy. Well, Guster played Friday night at the world's largest block party, and of course Third Eye Blind was last night. We get to Guster now. Stick around. Ben Bassett from Vintage Blue coming up with a live performance right after this on the Rock and Roll Radio program.